So it'll be Eric Day and Liam Crouch coming up. In the hands of Cleary for ISK as we start off. Cleary on the 3-point line. Sullivan for an early three. Doesn't go, but great rebound inside by Keelan Houlihan. Houlihan drives the basket. Doesn't get that, but good rebound by Mark Conroy. Thomas takes the three. Doesn't go. Rebounded by Sullivan. Houlihan just makes a mistake with that pass, and it's Convoy on the fast break here for the Jazz. Gets a bump, but goes up, and great finish there with left hand there. So Mark Convoy opens the scoring for the Jazz. Another 3-point shot there from... inside for Owen Sullivan. Owen Sullivan, as he goes round the defense and puts in a layup. So Sullivan works the ball around to O'Connor. Cleary takes a three. Doesn't go, rebounded by Mark Convoy for the Jazz. Summers slows it down. Ball behind the guard, James Dunham. Corner shot taken from Jack Brown, but doesn't go in, and O'Sullivan looks to set up the play for his game. Register their first points of the game. Keelan Houlihan gets it back to O'Sullivan. A nice baseline drive there from Darryl O'Connor, and he's fouled. That'll be the first foul of the game on Adam Corbett. Sullivan across to Houlihan. Houlihan top of the key, doesn't take the shot, but the shot is taken on by Cleary. Cleary misses, but rebounded inside by Casey, and he's called for the travel. So the ball will go back to the Jazz. They lead early, 4-0. So Duggan comes down the ball, set up the play. Summers looking to pass the ball inside, but Duggan's open the corner, just stepped on the line, the long two. Great shot from the corner there for Duggan, but just stepped the line, it's only a two, and early goals. Coach Johnny Buckley and Anna Maria O'Donoghue don't like what they've seen. YSK, they call a quick timeout. So the Jazz quickly back out of the court after timeout. Keen to keep playing as they lead 6-0. So ISK hoping just to calm the nerves a little bit there. As Dara Cleary brings the ball up and calls the play. As Cleary open on the 3-point line. O'Connor looks to drive. Cleary will take the three. Doesn't go. And great rebound by Convoy. Starts the fast break. Logan Morder just loses the handle on it, and it's stolen by O'Connor. Gets the forward to O'Sullivan. Sullivan tries to get inside there to Houlihan, but he can't hold the ball, and Summers takes off on the fast break. Long three-point shot from Convoy, doesn't go in. Casey gets the rebound, he'll get it forward to O'Sullivan, who finds O'Connor in turn. O'Connor chooses not to shoot Houlihan, makes the drive, makes tough pass inside, but O'Connor can't keep hold of it, and Summers again. We'll look to start the fast break as he drives down the middle lane, doesn't make the shot, but good rebound by the athletic Owen O'Sullivan. ISK, they still looking for their first basket of the game. Zone just sitting back, protecting the basket here as O'Sullivan takes the three, doesn't get it, but kept in bounds. And Summers again looks to push for the Jez. Local Mora doesn't make that one, and Houlihan gets the rebound. Nice behind the back move on the fast break, he's still going. But good hands inside from Mark Convoy, and he's looking to push the fast break, pulls up for a short jump shot, makes an excellent jump shot there. Great pull-up jump shot there from Mark Convoy after he gets a steal, so it's 8-0 to the Jez, and they've definitely started the better of the two as they sit back in their zone defense, make it difficult for ISK to get anything easy inside. So far they've been relying on outside shots, but O'Sullivan drives, takes a little floater, doesn't get it. Rebounded between Convoy and Summers. And Convoy gets it forward to Adam Corbett. Back in the hands of the point guard, Duggan. Corbett swings the ball. Good hands on defense by Cleary, he gets a steal, he's looking to penetrate, but slowed down by Corbett. Oh, good pass inside, but Houlihan can't quite get it, it comes off the knee of Convoy as ISK will make their first subs of the game, and it'll be the point guard Darragh Cleary being replaced by Liam Croke. Croke will get his first touch of the ball. They swing it, Darragh Casey back out, and it will be Croke who takes that three, and maybe that's what they're missing. Inspired substitution by the coaching partnership of Buckley and Donahue. Introduced Liam Coke in the game, and he gets their first score straight away with a nice three-point shot from the top of the key. Inside, Convoy doesn't make that one. Houlihan looks to push the fast break. Just fumbles the ball, but they've still got it. He runs into three Jez defenders, just stopping the basket. Come off Summers there, but looked to stand on the line, but it's got away with it. Good hustle by Darragh Casey. And he'll find O'Connor. O'Connor across the throat, and O'Sullivan will take a three. And he makes it, and now we saw all of a sudden see what ISK can do as they make back-to-back three-point shots. So the Jez philosophy of stopping the drive worked early on, but ISK have counteracted that by making a three. And Summers takes a three of his own, doesn't make that. Casey gets the rebound and gets it out to Houlihan. Houlihan looks to penetrate, finds O'Sullivan on the three-point line. Croke, they swing the ball well. So Conn looks to drive, but there's nowhere to go as someone moves his feet quickly. Some good defense. And it'll be ISK ball from the end line. Sullivan out to Houlihan. Houlihan takes a long two. Bounces off. Good rebound by Lorcan Mordor. And here comes the point guard, James Duggan. Duggan again in the corner, but good hands from ISK, and ends up going out of bounds. Good hustle by Mordor, but can't keep it in. And after a great start, they led 8-0. Coach Adrian O'Sullivan for the Jez takes a timeout to talk it over. As ISK are back at this one, it's 8-6. So here we go, 1:14 to go in this first quarter. Zayas, Cape and Clogan with the ball as they trail 8-6. Croke swings the ball around, Houlihan finds Sullivan in the corner, he looks to penetrate, gets to the middle of the key. Looks to find Kevin Fitzgerald, who's checked in for Clogan, but just knocked out of bounds off the hands of Duggan. So Croke will look to pass it in, he finds Fitzpatrick, gets across to Sullivan, and O'Connor finds the cut in, Houlihan in the corner. Houlihan tries to find Fitzpatrick in the middle, but again, great defense by Convoy. He just gets hands on it on the out of bounds. Far side to ISK. And they find the opener. Open Croke for three, and he makes another one. That's 2 for 2 for the same spot. So he and Croke, and he's made a huge difference as ISK take the lead. 9-8. Now he's showing energy on defense, and he creates the turnover. As Duggan, it's actually Mordor, can't quite make the pass, it goes out of bounds, and Croke's really made a huge impact in this game since he came on, both offensively and defensively, swinging the ball from side to side. Houlihan looks to penetrate in the middle, but again, yeah, he's called for an offensive foul. The Jets really pack in the middle of that key. There's no chance that they're going to let any of the ISK players get into the middle. They're going to have to beat them from the outside, which for the last couple of shots they've managed to make a few, but the Jets are banking on the fact that it won't be able to continue for the whole game, so that's the challenge put in front of ISK. Jets look to attack the basket, and Duggan takes a fake, takes a tough jump shot from the baseline, doesn't make it. Good rebound by Fitzpatrick, but good hands by the Jets, can't quite get it, and Houlihan as the clock expires at the end of the corner. So at the end of a very topsy-turvy quarter, it's ISK leading the Jets, the U16B boys final by 9.8. Welcome back to the National Basketball Arena. The U16B boys final, second quarter just underway, with ISK and Colaiste just leading the Jets from Galway by 9.8. The steal by ISK. We start off slowly, but they've come right back into this on the back of some great three-point shooting, especially by Croke. But Houlihan looks to drive inside, but again there's no space, and Convoy gets hands on the ball, and someone's up to bring it up. Avoids the backcourt violation. Back out, and Convoy takes a three, doesn't make it. Yeah, Croke just travelled there, didn't put the ball on the floor before he took a step. So Brown on the floor for Jez. Convoy doesn't make that one. Croke whips the ball across court in turn. Sullivan does the same. Sullivan's open three-point line. O'Connor looks to penetrate the baseline. Sullivan moves feet, but not quickly enough, says the referee, and that'll be the end line ball. I think that's the first foul on Summers. So ISK quickly moves the ball around the outside of the key. Croke looks to penetrate the baseline, but stolen this time by Jack Brown. Good hands by Croke as he continues to play well. Summers for three in the corner. He makes that. Great shot from the corner by Evan Summers. And he puts the Jets back in the lead. 11-9. Good ball movement by ISK as they get it to the open. O'Sullivan in the corner can't make that, but great hands from Fitzpatrick as he gets him another chance. Houlihan looks to drive. Croke penetrates the middle, finds Sullivan, quickly swing O'Connor. O'Connor takes a long two, doesn't go, rebound by Convoy, gets it out to Summers. ISK do a great job of getting back on the fast break, And Jess looking to set up a play. Goes in the corner. Summers again. He's just made room for Mayo. Just off on that occasion. And the O'Sullivan bringing the ball up by SK. Patrick looks to drive back out to Houlihan. Houlihan looking for an open man. O'Sullivan. Croke would take another 3-point shot. He's been deadly accurate so far, but that one's just off. And yet another rebound there for Convoy. Gets it forward. Oh, great move there. Lorcan Mortar. Had a few unlucky calls earlier, but makes a great finish there and gets fouled, so he'll have a chance to go to the line for a 3-point play. Great left-handed finish. We saw that in, I think, the first minute of the game. Doesn't make that. It's rebounded by Houlihan. Jazz have a 4-point lead here as they lead 39. Just over 5 minutes to go in the quarter as Fitzpatrick penetrates. Gets it back out to Croke, and O'Sullivan will take a three this time. He's already made one, but doesn't make that one. Convoy's dominating under the boards there for the Jazz, but doesn't make a great pass there, and it's picked off by Croke, who finds O'Connor. O'Connor takes the floater, doesn't go. Rebound by Brown. Great pass. Morgan Border gets another finish, so he's got back scores on the lane. Great pass break that time by the Jazz, and they lead again by six. O'Sullivan open on the three-point line, just steps over the line, doesn't make it. Day rebounding. Oh, great pass that time by Moore. This time he just goes to the basket, flips the ball inside the Convoy. And again, a great fast break, and the Jazz have refound their form. They lead 70-9. Croke just fakes the shot. Steal this time. Summers takes another three, doesn't go. Good rebound by O'Connor, and gets the ball back in the hands of Croke. Houlihan will take a long two this time. Again, just bounces out. And Summers looks forward, but decides not to give it to Mora. Keeps holding the ball and sets the play. We get a lot of movement here, the Jazz trying to break down the zone from ISK, and Convoy makes the play, doesn't go. Houlihan gets all the basket, but that one just rolls out. But he'll go to the line for two shots. There were 3:19 to go in the U16B boys' final. It'll be Keelan Houlihan stepping to line for two shots as ISK trail the Jazz by 17-9, but he makes that one to cut the deficit to 10. Yeah, to 7, sorry, is it 17-10? Doesn't make that one. A good rebound by Convoy. Gets the ball out to Summers. Over to Brown. Summers takes a sweep in the corner. He made another one. He made one from the other side, then missed a couple, so he decided to change corners and shows his shooting accuracy again by making a great three-point shot to put the Jazz up 10. And great steal by Brown. He's looking to go over to the basket. Croak gets back, but again, Convoy chases up his rebound, misses, but gets the rebound again. Misses again, but gets the rebound again. And this time he's good. Got three attempts, offensive rebounding. Mark Convoy's proven to be dominant force under the boards, both ends here. Summers grabs up the missed shot. And again, the zone, they're forced to extend a little bit to stop the three-point shooting of Summers. But Convoy's been very good inside, and he'll find Mortar. Great shot there. Mortar's really coming into the game now. He's made his last three. And the lead is a little bit critical by SK here as they've struggled to score since making those early three-point shots, and it's 24-10. We have a jump ball call, and it'll be ISK ball. So the coaching duo of John Buckley and Amrio O'Donoghue looking to find a way to break down this zone, ably assisted by James Doyle down there on the bench. So making a couple of subs here, and it's Dara Casey's checking into the game. You'll be hoping he can prove a big scoring threat. As the defense has been okay, but they've just struggled to put the ball in the basket a little bit, and it's O'Connor here. Sullivan chooses not to shoot. Gets over to Houlihan. And again, they just can't penetrate that key. But there is the new man, Casey. The 24-second clock violations called by the referee. And it'll be the Jazz ball as they lead by 14 here with 1:39 to go in this first half. And the sharp shooting Summers gets the ball to Brown. Inside a Convoy, and a foul's called. Be a shooting foul. It's going against number 12, Owen O'Sullivan. So that'll be his first foul. Convoy just has his first shot, bounce out. Second one just rubs off, and Houlihan with the rebound. Slow down there by Convoy, but gets the ball to O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan drives the basket. Summers slows the ball down. New man, Owen Day, recently checking the game, gets a touch. Convoy takes a long shot. The referee just says he's stepping the line, but again, a great jump shot will be worth two. So the Jazz continue to rack up the scores behind some great shooting and good inside play. And it's 26-12 as O'Sullivan takes the bounce shot, doesn't go. Rebound Summers, and they've got numbers. Definitely got rid of the travel there. He took three steps to pass the ball, but good hustle by Mortar. Knocks the ball over O'Sullivan, and it'll be the Jazz ball from the end line. 38 seconds to go in this half, leading by 16. And again, they've left Summers open in the corner. Doesn't make this one, but rebounded by Casey and gets it forward to Croak. Croak to O'Connor. O'Connor looks to penetrate, but again, a great defense, this time by Day. Doesn't allow him to penetrate, and a misplaced pass. And Brown's going to get hands on this one. He's going to avoid the basket. And he makes the layup there. The Jazz really are playing some great basketball on either end. So it's 14 seconds to go. The clock ticks towards 10 seconds. Inside to a great score this side from Dara Casey. He gets the goal 5 seconds to go, and Summers looks at the clock. He got one more chance, but great defense as Brown gets a chance to put it up. It doesn't go. And there we have halftime. And after a great start, ISK came into it a little bit in the back of 3 3-point shots, but since then they've struggled to score with just 3 points. And at the end of the first half, the Jazz lead ISK on the scoreline of 28-12. Rejoin us back in about 3 or 4 minutes. Welcome back to the National Basketball Arena here. We just get underway to start the second half. The ball in the hands of James Duggan for the impressive Jez. As they lead by 28 points to 12. So Summers looks set up the play, gets it to his captain, Lorcan Morda. Gay, who stayed in the game after subbing in late in that half, and he's fouled. I think it's going to go against O'Sullivan, so it'll be two shots. It is. The foul goes against Owen O'Sullivan. So he'll go to the line for two shots. Just rolls out with the first one. He'll get another chance to extend this lead. No mistake for the second one. Darkly with the ball for ISK, he finds O'Sullivan, who fakes the shot, drives in, great pass inside, but rebounded by Hulan, but he can't make that, and Condry gets the rebound there. Summers looks to drive all the way, good defense by Hulan, and that'll be a charge, yeah. He was in front of Summers. Darkley looks to set it up. O'Sullivan takes a three, doesn't go. Rebound by Convery. So Morda gets a screen from Convery, gets in the middle of the key, pulls it back out. Great backdoor cut. Summers just took just too many steps there. Great backdoor screen, a backdoor cut by Summers, but took three steps instead of two on the way to the layup, but play was waved off. So it'll be ISK trailing 29-12. Clary finds Hulan in the corner, puts the ball behind his back, but can't get past Summers. This time he does. Goes to the basket, but good defense here, doesn't make it, and Summers pushed on a fast break. Side on the pass a day, goes to Morda instead. Morda, great drive down the middle, and he puts the ball in the basket. He had a shaky start the first minute and a half, but ever since then, the captain has really been leading by example here for the Jazz. He's scored 8 quick points, got a couple of steals and an assist to boot. Day waits for the screen, decides not to use it. Got away with a carry, didn't get away with a carry. Referee saw that one there, he didn't quite put the ball to the floor fast enough. That'll be ISK ball. But they're struggling to score here badly. They've been kept by the good defense from the Jazz. So just a couple of three-point shots, or 3 3-point shots in the first quarter. As we go for another three, and that one goes in. Great three-point shot by Roland Moriarty's. He gets his first basket of the game. But they're going to need a lot more of that if they get back in this game. The Jazz have been very impressive so far. Summers takes a two. Doesn't go. Moriarty follows up with three with a rebound. And Casey gets the ball back to O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan finds that man again in the corner. This time Moriarty can't make that. Here comes Morda. Swings the ball, just eludes Houlihan. Summers goes to the basket, he's fouled. Looks like that's going to go against Moriarty. It is, so that'll be the first foul on Moriarty, and it'll be Summers to the line. He's been very impressive shooting three-pointers in his first half, and he makes no mistake with the foul shots. Doesn't make the second one, rebounded by Dara Casey. Gets the 4-4 to Houlihan. Good pass from Houlihan to Moriarty, but Moriarty can't finish then. Condry gets the rebound. But good defense there, great hustle by Cleary as he tries to get himself. Oh, wow, got away, definitely away with a travel there as Houlihan jumps in the passing lane. But not seen by the referee. So it'll be the Jazz looking to go inside with Convoy, take the shot, doesn't go, gets the own rebound though, missed again, this time O'Sullivan with a rebound and he gets it forward to Houlihan. Houlihan with defense and Summers, but Houlihan goes up and over Summers and makes a good turn. A little bit of a score and run here as ISK have 6 points, 6 points and a couple of lead, it's 32-17 now. Morbeck just gets away with a little bit of a push off, but may have gone down a bit easier O'Sullivan, but it'll be, here comes Houlihan, and a foul is called this time, and that seems to have gone against Adam Corbett. That'll be his first. Moriarty across to Sullivan. A travel's call on Sullivan there, he didn't get the ball on the floor fast enough. Day gets the ball back to Summers. Jez look to set something up here on offense. Good screen underneath, finds Morda. Morda back out, it'll be Convoy for a long three, all that in and out. Good rebound there by Cleary. Cleary's looking to push in the first break. Cleary pulls up for a tough 2-point shot, but that's a little bit backboard. And the crowd in the forward line stay up from Colaiste today. Find their feet and give them something to shout about. They pull this game back a little bit, it's down to 13-point lead. It's been up as far as 20 at one point. Day in the corner, pressured by Cleary. A foul is called, Cleary just reaches a little bit too much, gets too much contact on the arm. So it'll be sideline ball to Jez. And O'Sullivan takes a break there as Croke comes back in. He hit a couple of three-pointers in the first half, so he'll be hoping for more of his shooting. Summers, defense, good defense from Cleary as he gets hand the ball, gets a steal. But Houlihan dives the ball, Summers gets it back. They tie up, and that foul goes against Cleary. As him and Conway get tied up going for the ball. I think that's going to be his second foul, it is, second in quick succession. Convoy gets inside and finishes right with his left hand. Houlihan in the corner, ties up the shoot, gets the ball out to Croke. Croke reverses it to Moriarty. Moriarty's fouled, looks like it's on Day, it is going to be on Day. So just gets called for the push. Actually called on James Duggan there, sorry. Moriarty takes another three, this one doesn't go, rebounded by Convery. Convery finds the impressive Evan Summers. James Duggan inside to Convery. Convery doesn't make that shot, but great hustle on the rebounds from Adam Corbett, doesn't get it in the end, and Cleary comes away from it, he'll find Houlihan, caught good spin by Houlihan. Houlihan can't get the ball, and Combe gets the rebound, and Summers off on a fast break straight away. The ball just doesn't roll there for ISK, and the lead remains 15 points at 34-19, and foul is called on number 8, that would be Dara Casey, just a push in the back, and with 2 minutes to go, ISK have moved into team penalty, so every time there's a foul out, it'll be two shots to Jez. And on this occasion, it'll be Mark Convoy going to the line for two. Four short with his first. Timeout by ISK as they just want to talk this over. They've had a little bit of a run in this third quarter, but The Jays have seen it and matched it, and they lead by 16 as the coach takes the teams for a timeout. So the players take the court with 2:06 to go in the third quarter. It's the Jays from Galway leading the ISK from Killorglin 35-19. As Cope brings the ball up, finds Cleary, reverses the ball to Houlihan. Houlihan take a long shot, but Mordra adds to his impressive stat line with a block. Adam Corbett can't quite rein that one in from Summers, and Coco set the ball up for ISK. So they find Houlihan in the corner. He's guided by Summers. Houlihan back to Coke. Coke tries to penetrate into the middle but can't get quite get in it. Pass it back out, and Cleary will have a look again. He finds Moriarty. Moriarty makes a nice spin move. Finds it open Coke from the top of the key, and he can't make that 3-point shot. That's been his specialty out of the gate. But Cleary picks up his third foul as he just gets called for a push on James Dunham. And Dunham will go to the line with two shots. Don't forget, any budding young basketball players out there, that this summer will be the 44th Basketball Ireland Macron Kitts National Camp, taking place at Gormanstown College from the 5th to the 10th of July, and then again from the 12th to the 17th of July. So if you want to come improve your skills, go on to www.basketballireland.ie. And go onto the camp page, you'll see some videos and pictures from previous years, along with all the details of how to register. The camp's filling up fast, so don't delay and get your registration in as soon as you can. Croak out to Moriarty. Moriarty takes a jump shot from the wing but doesn't go, and here comes Summers looking to push the ball. Houlihan just turns out in time to slow him down, and Duggan gets the ball into Cogley out to Summers, and Summers is another three. That's his third of the game. He's been very impressed with both ends of the court today. Again, you see his good defense there on Houlihan, but Houlihan eventually gets it out to Moriarty. Moriarty to Croak. Croak finds Cleary on the edge, but again, it's difficult to penetrate. Great spin move, a great move there. He's got Houlihan as he spins into the middle of the lane and finishes his left hand. A great move, he's fouled, and he'll get the two, and he'll have a chance to add to his tally with a bonus free throw. Doesn't make the extra, but great hustle that time. Casey gets it out to Cleary, but Cleary can't make the shot, and it'll be out of bounds. It'll be the Jez ball. 35 seconds to go in the quarter. Currently leading by 18 points, 39-21. Mordek gets the ball over the halfway line. Finds Duggan. Inside the Convoy. Convoy makes a pass inside, but Corbett couldn't finish. And the ISK with the chance to cut this deficit in the last play of the quarter. So he's been called the travel, so the Jays will get a chance to extend their lead. With 7.3 seconds to go, O'Connor checks back in for Cleary as he's got a bit of foul trouble, but 7 seconds to go. Convoy looks long, it's just outrun. Great fake by Convoy, but can't make it. And Moriarty ends up with the ball as time expires. So at the end of three quarters, the Jets continue to lead here against ISK with a scoreline of 39-21. So the fourth quarter about to get underway here as Coach Buckley and O'Donoghue just give some final instructions to ISK. They fought Marvin in that third quarter and had a little bit of a run. Try and get back into it, but the Jays eventually found their feet and continue to lead. They're up 18 here, so it'll take a monumental effort from ISK, but they certainly haven't given up. And if they can continue the sharp shooting from the three-point line, they've every chance to get back into it, but the Jays aren't giving up anything easy and make it very difficult as Croke takes a three. Let him get there. They need all those to go. And great hustle by Duggan. And he finds Summers. Summers will find a wide open Convoy inside. And those two have been a great partnership inside. Summers and Convoy just continue to score and rebound at will. And they've been one of the big difference along with Logan Mortar. The Jets, yes, they move again from Houlihan, and again he makes it. Not sure what's happened there. Referees have blown a stop to the game. I think they're just looking to see if there's any blood on Mark Convoy, but there isn't. Gets into Summers. Summers finds Mortar. Mortar looks to penetrate. Goes to the left hand, misses. A good rebound by Owen Evans, who's checked into the game here for ISK. Houlihan looks to penetrate, finds O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan goes for three. And he hits nothing but nets. ISK found a little bit of a scoring touch here, and they've cut this lead down to 15 as they put the full court press on. It's broken. James Duggan got away with a carry. Didn't go with a carry again. Referee's on top of it again. Just as a tendency on that left hand, just to carry the ball a little bit when he's going at speed. He can call it a couple of times that's something he has to work on. But ISK with the score here could just send a little jitters into the Jays. It's always tough to get across the finishing line when they've gone this game. Moment. O'Sullivan looks to penetrate. He pulls up for a short shot, but great defense. The hands of Owen Day gets the handle, but inside there. And O'Connor at this tally. Summers looks for a quick drive, but Houlihan gets hands on the ball and can't quite get it, but Colson gets hands on it. He's not. Mortar gets hands on the ball. Cross-court pass to Summers. Summers looks inside for Convoy, but great. That's the jump balls there. Call with Owen Evans and Convoy. Very unlucky from Evans. He did a great job of getting his hands on that and definitely looked the favourite to win that one, but and the lead has cut to 13. Owen Evans has been given his best job of marking Mark Convoy inside because he's been dominant. Pays dividends there as Duggan throws the ball away, and it's ISK, and all of a sudden you just sense the momentum changing a little bit. It's a long way back for them, but all of a sudden the guys in Colaiste just start to believe a little bit, and they've upped their intensity on defense, and the Jays will have to pull themselves together here to continue this lead. But their defense has been excellent so far. But Houlihan open at the top of the key. O'Sullivan's open again for three. He'll take that. That's looking good. And again, O'Sullivan makes that three. As the Jets and the coach of Aidan O'Neill rushes the table to get a 3-point line, to get a timeout then, get hold of his troops and just discuss it. So they relied on giving ISK outside shots, but ISK have suddenly started hitting a couple there on Neil Sullivan, and as they take a timeout, the lead is down to 10. Welcome back. It's 6 minutes, 6 seconds to go, and ISK put on a full court press. They've really upped the intensity in this fourth quarter, and they've dragged it back from 20 point deficit. There's a steal by O'Connor, and O'Connor makes the layup, and now it's down to 8. And a little bit of panic showing here, but Captain Logan Moore gets the ball. He takes control. He's looking to fast break. And Sunderland makes the stand, doesn't get it. Conroy gets the rebound, and Conroy puts it back in. And just settles the nerves a little bit. Conroy is 14 points. Houlihan drives in. With a foul called. Not sure who that's going against. It's going against James Duggan. That'll be his second foul. So it'll be end line ball. Ball goes into Evans. Evans swings it across. So to O'Connor on the far side. O'Connor's not being guarded, but chooses not to shoot. Houlihan looks to penetrate in the middle. And a foul is called again. I think it's going to go against Conroy, I think. And that's his third. They can't afford to lose him. In the summers of... The buzz is gone, I think. I think someone's called a timeout. I'm not sure here yet. And we have a timeout call. We're going to call a timeout. They just want to discuss it in separate end line play. So with 5:30 to go in this final quarter, ISK have cut the lead, and it's the Jazz leading 43-33. So the end line ball to ISK. They tear by 10. They cut their steps in half in this fourth quarter on the back of some fine shooting and some really aggressive defense. Ball goes into Houlihan. They want to play here. Sullivan, the sharp shooter. Sullivan takes the three, doesn't make it. He made his last 2-3. And Conroy, the great pass up to Mora. Mora goes to his left hand, and he makes the layup as well. So a bit slow getting back in transition defense there from Colaiste. Allowed easy basket. Houlihan goes for his pattern spin move, but doesn't get it, and it's just gone back over half court. There was a dive from O'Sullivan, doesn't quite make it in time. James Duggan picks himself up off the floor for the Jazz to take the ball, and he'll pass it in. Again, ISK denying all the passes. Defense, but the ball goes in to Logan Mora. He steadies the ship here. And Duggan receives. Conroy has the ball, but good defense this time again. And it's O'Connor. Gets the ball behind his back, finds the open O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan's open, chooses not to shoot the three, drives to the basket, but good hands there from Summers, can't get it. Into the hands of Evans, Evans gets his hands in, and O'Connor makes the two. Great one-handed finish from O'Connor, and Summers breaks the press. Goes over the basket, doesn't make it, but good rebound inside by Owen Day, and that allows Mora to get to the basket. And the Jazz are fighting manfully here, but they just keep giving up easy layups. They're just allowing the Jazz to keep the nerves away and keep ticking over. They need to try and make sure that the Jazz only get long range shots in order to win this game. But the fans of the Jazz, they've shown that they can move the ball around and penetrate the key. Just checking on James Duggan. He looks a bit groggy out there after he took a bang, but he's going to fight on. So Croke swings the ball to O'Sullivan. And Owen Evans came on late in this, early in this quarter for the first time, and he's really made a difference here, making a basket, but also doing an excellent job on defense on Convoy. Oh, and a push from behind there on Houlihan. That'll be their first foul of the quarter, so it'll be a sideline ball. So the lead has just got stuck here at 10, so the Jets won't mind whilst they trade baskets at 10. We have a sub here. Croke takes a seat. Convoy open for two. That's a goal. Great rebound. Great rebound in there by Owen Day. And he puts the two back in, and the lead is back up to 12. Ooh, gets that spin move. Nice pass inside. Blocked by Convoy. O'Sullivan swings it, comes across to Houlihan. Houlihan fakes the shot. He drives up and under move, gets that one to go. Great finish by Houlihan. He does much better second half, but he watch his fouls there. He might go away with one there, but Summers slows it down. It's still 10. 3 minutes to go. Mortar drives down the middle, but a good stand. It doesn't make a difference. O'Sullivan makes a good stand, but Mortar shows a calm head to score up over him off the backboard, and again puts it up 12. Sullivan takes the three, penetrates inside, gets it to Houlihan. Houlihan trying to get inside, doesn't make it. Owen Evans just saved it, but it's stolen by Day. And here comes Convoy. Great move in the open court, doesn't make that. And O'Sullivan gets hands of the ball. He's a judge to have stood in the line there. Didn't look like he did from here, maybe got a push, but he's been unlucky that occasion. So it'll be sideline ball. Jack Brown looks to pass it in, gets into Convoy. He definitely stood in the line that time, but that time it's not seen, and there you see the small margins. Didn't look like ISK did stand on the line and got called for one. Convoy goes to the basket and makes that. And that's costly when you're trying to come back. Yeah, ISK looked like he didn't stand on the line, got called for one, and then no doubt about it, right in front of the bench, the Jets stood on the line, it didn't get called, but that's the kind of luck you need in these games. As they lead by 14, it hasn't come down to luck. You can be rest assured on that. They've been the better team throughout. ISK haven't given up, but still trying to come back. But Convoy gets a block on Evans. Ooh, Summers falls hard, but not fouled. I think he just got his feet tripped up. But Mark Convoy continues to be extremely productive as he blocks another shot and leads to a fast break. But it's a 14-point lead. It's 1:51 to go in this under 16B boys final. Score 53. Houlihan can't get that one. A travel call there. Mortar just shuffled his feet. So 1:35 to go, 14 down. This one's got to go down. Doesn't go, Connan. Convoy, as he has been doing all game long, gets the rebound. Sullivan looks for a long pass, but Sullivan's down. He gets past. He gets past Day originally, but Day goes back and gets the ball. Great pass from Day to Mortar, but Mortar can't make that. But Convoy again gets the rebound, doesn't get it inside. Day has it for it. And Day gets it back. And quick shot from Duggan sends Adrian O'Sullivan below us apoplectic as he wants him to slow it down, but they're up 14 with under a minute to go, so they should be fairly safe now as ISK struggle to try and get an open shot, and it comes off the foot of Houlihan, who's had an excellent game in this second half, but not been able to fight it back as we've got subs coming in with 48 seconds to go. Evans has just taken a bang there, so he's going to go to the bench, and he's joined by O'Connor, who again has been excellent for ISK, but the Jets have really put on a great performance today, and especially this man, Mark Convoy. but this time it's a steal by Cleary. Cleary looks to go to the basket, makes the pass to Houlihan, and he gets that basket. It's down to 12, with 35 seconds to go, so not enough time to get back into this one unless something amazing happens, but foul is called there. As Dara Casey fouls to try and stop the clock, but they're not in team penalty, so it'll be a sideline ball. And the defense has sagged off. They've decided to foul there with a celebration start below us with the Jazz. Jazz start off very well, and you have to say have been worthy winners here today, but a great fight back in this final quarter from ISK. Really made a game of it. But the Jazz showed their quality in the end as they were able to just take care of the ball and get vital scores at vital times. Currently leading by 12, and Houlihan fouls again to stop the clock. So it'll be Summers that'll go to the line, leading by 12 points. And Houlihan fouls out there, but he's had an excellent game. He's been very proud of his performance in the second half, especially. And the Jets below us make some subs. The game is Paul Walsh will check in for the first game. He will face with Jack Brown. Another sub coming in here. Tony McDonough. Tony McDonough checks in. Owen Day has been excellent in his minutes there. He really has some key interceptions. Summers makes that shot. As Mickey Monaghan heads to the subs bench here as he's the crowd call his name, ask him to go in. So he comes on for the captain, Lorcan Moore, who's had an excellent game here. And the Jazz currently by 14 as the clock ticks down to 17 seconds. Cleary takes a three but doesn't make it. And this time basket goes in for number four, Rona Moriarty. The Jazz call a timeout just to try and make a stop, but Mark Wynn will check into the game for his first time, and he replaces the excellent Mark Convoy. Ball goes in, and as Mark Wynn gets his first touch, it goes up to Cleary. Cleary gets the rebound, the clock ticks down, 3-2, and that's the end. So on the buzzer, Rona Moriarty makes a score there. The end of the game there sees the Jazz come out triumphant at the Under-16B school's final, a score of 55-45, an excellent game. The Jazz really did deserve it, but ISK got to be proud of their performance. They really kept playing right till the end, and we'll leave you now to enjoy the presentations. Don't forget the Under-16B girls' final still to come.